Have you ever encountered a succubus or an incubus in your sleep who seduced you? These sex demons mean business and come as a lustful creature of the night. Every single human being has been seduced in their sleep. I encountered a succubus the other day. I guess, she desired to devour me, I was yet another of her victims, so it seemed. I didn't do any ritual nor called upon a succubus. However, I encountered a female ghost who proclaimed her love for me. There was nothing at all I could do to escape the lovesick ghost. The ghostly presence in my life must have triggered that a succubus came through. I don't really know. I have written a book, Endless Desire, available online at Amazon. The link is below. Click like if you like. You can subscribe to the Paranormal Life channel, so you would be informed of any further paranormal clips. I've countless out-of-body experiences which caused I could easily encounter ethereal beings from other more subtle realms. I was completely surprised encountering a succubus for the first time. I was surprised she didn't appear demonic as folklore portrays. I guess not all succubi or incubi would be of the demon race. I wanted to share this encounter with you. It was fascinating to have met a female entity from another realm, to say the least. I was intrigued and more interested in learning about extraterrestrial intelligent life forms than passionate encounters. Not all humans are into ghostly or demonic sex. I'm one of them who are more interested in the supernatural than anything else. In any case, this succubus approached me while I was fully conscious outside of my physical body. She appeared very enticing. I should divulge, you remain in a slight daze and your wakefulness doesn't last for too long. I found your soul, like your body also undergoes being asleep. I found on several occasions my soul self being asleep outside my body. My soul self would awake at a certain point, or most times my soul would remain in deep sleep. I found myself waking up outside my body. I was in my room. My soul lay straight, a few meters above my sleeping physical body. Incidentally, most times, I found my waking soul self elsewhere. This time it hovered above the body. Almost immediately I noticed a pretty young girl with extreme beauty standing erect next to my bed. She didn't say anything, but merely gazed at me intently. Her gaze was lustful. She resembled a feline with long ears, slanted eyes, and full mouth. She was exceedingly pretty with narrow hips and voluptuous body. She had a cat-like tail. She appeared exceedingly agile and vivacious. She was sexual and seductive looking. Her lustful gaze was inviting. I encountered her a second time in the astral realm during another out-of-body experience. Her face exhumed an impossible beauty. A light purplish light tan aura reflected her skin color. It was as if light shone from her face. I told her, "You're extremely pretty." She smiled slightly. I don't know what really transpired between us, because I couldn't maintain my lucidity much longer. I presume I must have had several encounters with her, but had no recollection upon awakening. My intent is not desire, but my intent is awareness. Perhaps the succubus was different. Perhaps she wanted love. I don't know. When you have an out-of-body experience, your sense perception is much greater. I merely looked at her and could fathom much. She appeared as a young teen, but she was actually thousands of years old, if not millions of years. Now, in my wakeful state, I ever wonder what it would be like to be seduced and subjugated by a pretty succubus. However, your state during an out-of-body experience would be exactly similar as in wakefulness, whatever you're conditioned in your wakeful life, it becomes replicated during an out-of-body experience. If I should encounter the succubus once more, I'd probably react in a similar vein as before. But these sex demons are renowned for compelling and forceful action. They get what they want, I presume.